हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड रिवाइज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस. नाउ इन टुडे क्लास वी टेक एंड रिवाइज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज व्हाट? ट्रायंगल. ओके डियर स्टूडेंट, इन दैट चैप्टर्स देयर आर सो मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ थ्योरम्स लाइक थैल्स थ्योरम, पाइथागोरस थ्योरम, ओके, and theorem based on the areas, ratio of the areas of two triangles. So first of all we take and discuss the two important question. First of all we discuss about the Thales theorem. What is the concept of Thales theorem? Dear students, according to Thales theorem if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, let's see, suppose that we have a triangle ABC. Okay dear students, suppose that we have a triangle ABC, okay, and a third line, we draw a third line parallel to any sides of the parallel to side BC. Okay, let us take PQ be a line which we draw parallel to side BC. Then the other two sides divided into the same ratio means according to Thales theorem according to Thales theorem, what AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon Q. So this is a very important result. Okay, different. This is a very important result related to what? Thales theorem. Okay, so please, dear students, please concentrate on that theorem. After that, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on Thales theorem. Now, this one we take and solve. Some important questions of your syllabus based on what? Based on Thales theorem. Let's see. We take a question. In the given figure, the question is, in the given figure, triangle ABC are there, DE parallel to BC, okay, and AD upon DB and AD upon DB is equal to 3 upon 5. If AC is equal to 5.6, find AE. Okay, and the figure is, first of all, in triangle ABC, let's see, here a triangle ABC is given. Okay, dear students, let's see, there ABC is a triangle given in which DE parallel to BC, okay, and the third line DE which is parallel to BC. Okay, first of all, let's see its solution. Dear student, in that triangle, what is the given? First of all, we write the given value. Given is what? AD upon BB, na? AD upon BB is given by what? 3 by 5, okay? And AC is given by 5.6, find A. Now, by Thales theorem, A is find that. Okay? Now, by Thales theorem. Now by Thales theorem we get AD upon DB is equal to what? AE upon EC. Okay, result, AD upon DB is equal to what? AE upon EC. This is according to Thales. So now we put, now let's see, the value of AD upon DB is what? 3 upon 5 is equal to AE. We find that, and EC is not given, so we write AE. We write AE in the form of AC minus EC. ओके बिकॉज ऑफ वी फाइंड ए ना ओके तो ए अपॉन ए सी सो ओके तो ए राइट एज इट इज एंड वी राइट ए ई वी राइट ए ई सी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए सी माइनस ए ओके तो ए राइट एज इट इज and we write EC as what AC minus AE okay AC minus AE okay now what I do now dear student we put the value of AC and we do their cross multiplication in this way we find the value of AE okay let's see so now let's see this is 3 upon 5 is equal to the value of AE which we find suppose we take as x we take the value of a as x okay now ac the value of ac is what 5.6 okay minus a we take as x now we do their cross multiplication so we get what let's see so 5x is equal to 3 into 5.6 minus x okay so 5x is equal to 3 into this 16.8 minus 3x respectively now we get 5x minus plus 3x no? and that's it also that's it 5x minus plus 3x is equal to what 16.8 okay 16.8 now so we get 538 so we get 8x is equal to what 8x is equal to dear students 16.8 that is the value of x is equal to 16.8 divided by 8 now we divide 16.8 by what 8 So let's see what I get. Let's see. 8 2 16, 1 8 1 8. Thus the value of AE. Thus the value of AE as what? 2.1. This is your required solution of the question. Okay, dear friend. Thus, this is the method to solve that type of questions. And so in this way, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on Thales theorem. In this way because of this is one of the most important question of your syllabus now we take and solve one more question of your syllabus based on Thales theorem okay let's see very carefully Let's see. And your question is what? In the given figure, A, B, and C are points. C are points. Okay, in the given figure, A, B. And C are points on OP OQ and OR respectively okay such that AB parallel to PQ and AC parallel to QR. Okay. Show that AC parallel to PR. Okay. Let's see. And now the figure is this is very important question, dear students. And the given figure is what? Let's see. This is a very important question of your NCERT exercise. This is PQR in a triangle. Okay, the given figure ABC are the points on the OP. Now, OP, OQ, and OB any point in its interior, and we join OQ, OR and OP are there, and here A, B, C are the points of OP. OP, this is A, okay, OQ as B, okay, and OR at C. Okay, now we show, have to show that AC parallel to PR. Now we join AC, BC, okay. Now we join AB, AC and BC, okay. This is the interior point. Now, this is the figure. Listen, this is very important question of your NCERT exercise, okay. So please concentrate there on that question, because this is one of the most important questions based on Thales theorem. So let's see solution, students. Let's see. Yes, sir. In proving, we have to show that AC parallel to PR. First of all, you AC is where? We have to show the AC parallel to PR. Okay. Now, first of all, we write given, and according to question, we have AB. Where is AB? AB parallel to PQ. Means AB parallel to PQ is given, and BC. BC parallel to QR. BC parallel to QR is given. Okay. Now, if dear friends, let's see. In triangle, first of all, AB parallel to PQ. AB where? AB parallel to PQ. Now in triangle OPQ. Now in triangle OPQ. Okay. Now in triangle OPQ, we get. Dear students, in that triangle OPQ, here we have AQ parallel to PQ. Since AB parallel to PQ, then by converse of Thales theorem, what? OA upon AP. OA upon AP is equal to what? OB upon BQ. Okay? Because of, you know that, na, according to Thales theorem, if any third side parallel to third side of any line segment parallel to third side of a triangle, then other two sides divided into the same ratio. So here we have AB parallel to PQ. Na? This is the given. This relation is given in our questions. So, dear friends, AB parallel to PQ are there. That is, if AB parallel to PQ, that is OA upon AP, OA upon AP is equal to OB upon BQ. OB upon BQ. Take question number 1. Similarly, let's see. Dear students, similarly, now, second relation is what? BC now in triangle OQR. Now, in triangle OQR. OQR we get. In triangle OQR, BC parallel to QR. BC parallel to QR, na? Okay, that is BC, since BC parallel to QR, that is OB upon BQ. OB upon BQ is equal to OC upon CR. OC upon CR. Okay, OC upon
CR.
So take question number 2. Now let's see. Now here let's see. OB upon BQ are there, and there are. So using equation 1 and 2. Now using equation 1 and 2. We get now using equation 1 and 2, we get what we get. Let's see. OA upon AP, okay. OA upon AP is same as OC upon CR. Now let's see. Dear friends, if we have OA upon AP is equal to OC upon CR, okay, then we can say that AC parallel to PR by Thales theorem. Thus, let's see question number 3. Thus, by Thales
theorem. Thus, dear friends, by Thales theorem, what? AC parallel to PR. Using equation 3. Using 3, we can say that the AC parallel to what? PR. Hence proved that result. Okay?
Thus, dear students, in this way, this is one of the most important question of your syllabus based on Thales theorem. So please do more and more practices of that type of question or questions based on the Thales theorem. Okay. Now we take and discuss about the next topic of that chapter, and we take and solve some important questions based on them. Let's see, dear students. Let's see about we take or solve the next topic of the chapter, which is we discuss about the next and a very important question. Let's see, in a trapezium, in the trapezium, okay, which is very important question. In the trapezium ABCD, comma AB parallel to CD, and AB is equal to CD. If the area of triangle AOB is 84 centimeter square, find the area of triangle COD. Okay, find the area of triangle COD. Okay, now let's see its solution. Let's see, dear sir, in that question, first of all, we draw what? Our trapezium ABCD. Let's see. First of all, we draw our trapezium in this way. Okay. And the trapezium is ABCD here. Now let's see. ABCD is a trapezium here. Now, AB parallel to CD here. AB parallel to CD. Okay. And now let us take an entire point. Now, if we join AC and DB, then and we take OB the point of intersection of these diagonals, then here from figure triangle AOB, area of triangle AOB is given by 84 centimeter square, and AB parallel to CD is given, and AB is equal to 2 into CD is the relation is given. We find what? Area of triangle COD is find that. So first of all, in that triangle, we have to show that both the triangles are similar to each other. So let's see from figure. Now in triangle AOB and triangle COD, we get triangle AOB. If we get in triangle, let's see now, angle AOB is same as angle COD. By these are the vertically opposite angles. Okay, these are what? Vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, and angle OAB is same as angle OCD. That angle is equal to that angle. Okay,
O, C, D. These are the alternate interior angles. Because of we know that dear student, if two parallel lines cuts by the transversal T, then in that condition the alternate interior angles are equal to each other. So here we apply that concept. Now thus by AD similarity, thus by angle similarity, similarity, triangle AOB is similar to triangle COD. So first of all, we have to show that both triangles are similar to each other. Now what I do? Now according to theorem, if two triangles are similar to each other, then the ratio of their areas is equal to the ratio of the square of their corresponding sides. So here, thus by theorem, area of triangle AOB upon area of triangle COD is equal to, this is AB square upon CD square, according to theorem. By theorem, we have a result as if two triangles are similar, then the areas of their ratio of their areas is equal to the ratio of the square of their corresponding sides. So here we that. Now we get as area of triangle AOB, we put that area of triangle AOB is 84. So here we put 84 upon this is, we find that area of triangle COD, we write as it is equal to AB square. AB is what? Our given relation is, given as what? AB is equal to 2CD. So here we write as, so 2 to the 2CD square upon this is CD square. Okay. Now, so in this way, dear student, here CD is CD square is cancelled to each other. So we get what? Let's see. Here we get 84 upon area of triangle COD is equal to what? 4 upon 1. Now we do their cross multiplication. That is area of what? Area of triangle what? COD. Area of triangle COD is equal to 84 upon 2. That 84 upon 2. That 4 2s are 8. 4 1s are 4. That is area of triangle COD is given by what? 21 in centimeter. This is the our required solution of the given question. Okay, so dear student, using that concept, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise. Now we take and solve the some important question based on the right angle triangle. Based on what? The right angle triangle. Okay, dear student, let's see. Now, dear students, we take a question P and Q. This is a very important question. P and Q are the midpoints. Are the midpoints of the sides? CA and CB. CA and CB. CA and CB respectively of a triangle ABC. Okay. Of a triangle ABC. Right angle at C. Okay. Right angle at C. Prove that first point is what? 4AQ square is equal to 4AC square plus BC square. Second one, 4BP square 4bb square is equal to 4bc square plus ac square. Okay?
And the third part is what?
4 into aq square plus bp square is equal to 5ab square. Okay, so first of all, P and Q are the midpoints of the side of triangle. Let's see. First of all, we draw a triangle A, B, C, right angle at C.
Right angle at C, na? Now, here, what?
P and Q are CA. The midpoint of CA is what? P and the midpoint of CB as what? Q. Okay, now, we join AQ as well as BP. Okay, now, for first point, in right angle triangle, this is like ACQ. ACQ, we get what? AQ square is equal to what? Hypotenuse square is equal to what?
Base square plus perpendicular square, na?
So AQ square is equal to what? Means CQ square or CQ square plus AC square plus what? AC square. Now we multiplied by 4 both the sides. Got here 4 AQ square and 4 AC square. So we multiplied by 4 both the side of that equation. So we get 4 into AQ square is equal to 4 into AC square is equal to plus this is CQ square. Now, since CQ is the midpoint of BC, na, so direction since CQ is equal to half of BC means BC upon 2.
CQ is equal to what? Half of BC.
So here we put the value of CQ as BC by 2. So we get directly. So we get as 4 into AQ square is equal to 4 into AC square plus BC by 2 whole square. Okay. This is 4 also here, no? Because of we multiplied 4 both the side of the equation. So we get as 4 into AQ square is equal to 4 into AC square plus BC square by 4 means BC square by 2 to the 4 here. 4 is that side also. 4 is here. So 4, 4 cancel to each other.
Okay, dear friends, 4, 4 what? Cancel to each other.
So we get what? We get as 4 AQ square is equal to 4 AC square plus this is BC, na? So here this is BC square. Hence proof. Hence proof.
Thus, dear friends, in this way we proved the first part of that result. Okay. Similarly, we can prove the second part. Let's see. Now for second part of that question, we assume the triangle BPC. Let's say BP.
So BPC. Okay. Now for second part. Now in triangle BPC. BPC. We get again apply. This is the right angle triangle. So BP square is equal to what? BP square is equal to what? This is BC square plus CP square. Okay. So we again multiply by 4
in both the side of that equation.
So we get 4 into BP square is equal to 4 into BC square plus 4 into CP square. From figure, CP is equal to what? Half of AC. Half of what? AC. Because B is the midpoint of AC, na? So we get B. So we take as 4 into BP square is equal to 4 into BC square plus we put as CP as what? Half of AC. So AC upon 2 whole square. So we get as what? 4 into BP square is equal to 4 BC square plus 4 into AC square by 4. 4, 4 cancel out. So 4 into BP square is equal to 4 BC square plus AC square. Hence proof. This is the second part of this question.
Thus, in this way, we prove the both the part of that equation. Now, dear students. Now, for the third part, proving the third part, you add equation 1, result 1 and 2. In this way, you get your third result. Okay? Thus, just in this way, today class, we take and revise a very important question of your NCERT exercise based on the chapter triangle. Now, first of all, dear sir, you revise all the questions which we discussed in that class. After that, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise. Now, dear friends, in next class, we take and solve some other important question based on triangles. Okay, dear friends. Now, thanks to all.